Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for the invitation. It's an important conference at such a high level with distinguished speakers and guests taking place in this admitting severe pandemic situation. Peace and stability in the Eastern Mediterranean is not simply a question of Cyprus' national interest, but also a test of European solidarity. We are deeply concerned about the illegal drillings, the activities taking place within our exclusive economic zone. Turkey, as well known, has escalated the tensions, and we have to plan and to create an alternative to our energy routes. We regret that Turkey has not heeded the repeated calls by the European Union. It's well known, the recent Council and the European Council conclusion to end the unilateral and illegal activities in the Eastern Mediterranean as well as in the Aegean Sea. The escalation of these tensions in our region, it's even more essential for the EU to build a united and solidarity Europe that is going to be able to meet all the challenges and face and defend the interests of the EU members. The latest provocation by Turkey, it's the recent decision to proceed with the opening of the Amorphostos area, known as Varosha as well. This is violating the status quo, and it's against the UN Security Council resolutions, both number 550 of the 1984 and 789 of the 1992. In Cyprus, for 46 years, people are waiting for a solution in the problem. This was going to be a part of an area that it's going to be part of the solution. Unfortunately, Erdogan is looking forward to a different kind of a solution. It's clear that Turkey is aiming at imposing a permanent division. I mean, the statements recently are clear. They are asking for a two-state solution. This, of course, opposed and is in absolute contradiction to the agreed basis of the bizonal bicommunal federation. And it's also against all the UN Security Council resolutions, the international law, and of course against the EU law and the principles and values. This is something that we are now facing, and I think the whole world is looking at what is happening right now. Thankfully, our close partners have shown their level of solidarity. On the other hand, the EU family has to show this diplomacy, and we have to be obliged to be more effective, let's say. We feel that the foundation of the European solidarity is evolving and a strategic culture is being forged in the Mediterranean region. For Cyprus, the situation is quite clear. For us, regarding the escalating tensions with Turkey, we want to be neighbors and friendly with all the countries. This is what we are doing. We are strengthening and increasing cooperation with all Mediterranean EU powers and all our neighboring states. The only exception to this is Turkey that escalates the threats against not just Cyprus and Greece, but I think we are. It's clear what is happening in the Eastern Mediterranean and the Middle East as well. Another example of our cooperation is the recent signing of the East Med Gas Forum Charter, where we have a modern and open and inclusive platform. This is for us a very clear welcome in any kind, for every country in the region that respects the international law to join the forum. And in this framework to cooperate, we want an inclusive and open state with positive agenda, and we welcome anybody. Again, Turkey is an exception to this call. As explained, Cyprus has no option but to continue to cooperate with all those that embrace common European principles and values, and of course, the international law. In this respect, we call Turkey to accept Cyprus' invitation and engage in negotiations to the Cyprus problem in good faith and always in accordance with the international law and with the objective of reaching an agreement both on the maritime delimitation and on the whole situation in Cyprus. Of course, there is always the right to go to International Court of Justice if this is what Turkey prefers. The European Union is looking for peace and stability. As such, we respect all the neighbors, we respect everyone's rights and the international law. We are used to provocation in our neighborhood, and as you can understand, the situation may become more hostile in the Mediterranean. Today, we speak about drilling and maritime zones, but inevitably, other challenges maybe arise and could be unforeseen as well. The answer to these questions are by no means easy, but any response to the current and emerging challenges must be a result of a collective action taken directly through the affected actors founded on common values and understanding, in full respect, of course, of international law and with the principles of good and neighboring relations. This is our aim. This is what we are building, trust, and we want to be a pillar of trust and common interest for the whole neighborhood. The Republic of Cyprus aims to promote this regional political-military cooperation in order to enhance security and stability for the whole region. Our cooperation both with Greece, Israel, Egypt, and many other neighboring countries is here. We are friendly states and we are aiming to increase our community and interests and our bilateral relationships, and this is what we are doing currently. In this effort, it is essential to have all neighboring states on board. Of course, we want to build sustainable synergies for cooperation on this crucial topic. We have initiated trilateral, quadrilateral, and of course bilateral defense cooperation mechanisms, and between Cyprus, Greece, Egypt, and between Israel, Greece, and Cyprus, and we are expanding this to trilateral and quadrilateral with Lebanon and with Jordan. We want to succeed on partnerships and have a collective security for our area, for the region as a whole. We also maintain and we are further enhancing a robust cooperation with France, the United States, the UK, and of course Greece, as well as many other countries. We strongly believe that the aggregate of all these partnerships, the common understanding of so many states, but also gradually increasing pressure from the EU, will eventually convince Turkey that its own interest is also to cooperate with everyone. Last but not least, allow me to express the hope that Cyprus, as an EU member, not only will continue to defend its interests and legal rights — we are always in favor of diplomacy and we want to explore all the possibilities with the support, of course, of the European Union on the basis always of international law, European law, the UN Council resolutions, and we want, by intensifying our efforts at the legal, political, and diplomatic level, to de-escalate all this and find a proper solution to the Cyprus problem as well, that is a catalyst for the whole region. Thank you very much.